spiderweb. I did a bird shat on him and he tried scraping it. Yo, what's up guys? It's those guys again. Don't want to point at me. That's weird. Yo, what's up guys? Wait, no, you fucking confused me.
Wait, let me restart that.
Compose yourself. Yo, what's up? It's those guys here, and we're currently at a World War One abandoned farmland. As you can currently see, if we pan all the way round, we're just in the middle of woodland, but this woodland is right next to open fields, so we've got to be discreet because I'm not too sure how much farmers would want us being right here. But as you can see behind me, we've got like a little outhouse, maybe like some sort of granny annex back then. And when we first arrived here, wanted to check it out, make sure it was abandoned. And a fucking barn owl flew the fuck out of us. Thought it was some Harry Potter Hogwarts shit. About to drop my letter off. And if you just pan to the wooden building, that's just been fly tipped in. I can only guess that was also used for storage, possibly. And
have a little look inside this one.
Do you want a...
Oh, what is that? Gross.
Right, for this one, guys, as well, we both might be behind the camera. I've got a little light here just to give you guys some light in. After the first video testing it out, we saw we needed some light in. So, and this is our best solution for now until I order something else.
See, I haven't actually seen this yet, so I'm excited. Oh my God. That blinded me. It's still blinding me.
I don't need to go in there.
All right, let's have a little look.
Is it on one times? Put on one times.
It is now. Oh wow, yeah, that's beautiful. What is that?
It's like a chicken pen, isn't it?
I thought it was. I didn't want to say it in case I was wrong. Sound like an idiot. What the hell is that?
And obviously, that's where the owl must have come out earlier.
Okay.
Don't know who set this up because this land has been abandoned. Must be the local farmers just using it.
Yeah, quite possibly. There's not really too much to this first little area. Let's have a little look.
So this is the first building we're coming out of. This is a very photogenic spot, I think.
Yeah.
Ah, stone building. It's like a fucking start of a pyramid, the way they've done
the
that.
The very top?
No, like the bottom.
Oh, I see, yeah.
It's very strange, isn't it?
It's very weird. I don't know how we're going to get in there. Let's have a look at this first.
Got the amount of flies.
Yeah, there's quite a lot. Massive hay bales in there still. But they've got no access to it because they've got to go through this front bit.
Oh yeah, they must be.
What even is all this stuff?
I don't know how he's gonna get towards all the hay bales.
God knows.
Make our way to the house.
Yeah, there's not really too much to explore there. No. It's mainly this that is the main focal point of
what I've seen around the area, guys, this whole area was used for like World War One transit, World War One camps for our troops and that. So we might even just do an abandoned slash a hiking video where we hiked all the World War One camp areas and then also include this. Tell us what you think about this style of video where we've included an abandoned and maybe a hiking information segment. It's a bit different.
There's a little thingy over there, it looks like a little bridge maybe.
Fuck me, I nearly tripped over some fines.
Do we want to go over there first?
Let's do this first. It looks like it's all collapsed in. Probably no second floor by now.
Mate, this is so creepy.
Just for context. Look at this.
Oh yeah, there's a way in here.
And if we take this corner, go in it.
Oh God.
Go on. I'm trying to keep it on one time just to keep that quality.
This is really creepy. I've never been to a place like this before.
This is literally, like, guys, we could actually die here, but obviously, I'm a big man, I could survive that falling on me.
Don't know about me.
Look at that fireplace.
Look at the doors. I know the doors aren't like that old, but they look old.
Well, this has been abandoned since World War II or something, I've read.
It's crazy seeing like...
This wall is caving in.
Seeing parts of it, that are like, oh my God, yeah, look at it.
Yeah, it's fucking...
Right, I came through the first door. You're going through the second. He's got to squeeze through there.
Oh my God, look, the spider web's hanging on
first. That's why you'll go first. Or you go there and risk getting all that over you.
Chlamydia.
I've got a little hole in the floor down there too.
Oh fuck. Will it need more lighting for this bit?
I don't know.
Know what? I might prop the bag. I might prop the bag somewhere here. Right, I'm going in now, guys. Coming in it?
Am I coming in? Oh. Oh.
Do you know how much better this looks with the light? Nice.
Oh, I hate spider so much.
Same. Oh. There's literally, you put this on, you're able to press 0.5. Yeah, if I do the light quick. Do 0.5 to show the way. It's literally just filled with mud.
Lovely.
Ceiling's got holes in.
So there is a little hole down there that you could go into.
Yeah, I'd rather not.
Just be, down there.
Be like the putty cave or whatever that guy got stuck in.
No, don't say that. Yeah.
Ain't really much. No.
Is it really, is there?
Well, you're just in here. Do you want to pan under here? The stairs. Just while I've got the light. Okay. I want to try getting through this gap. Are you going for that? I'll do it.
The gap to the left?
Yeah, I'll do it.
That just takes you in there.
Huh?
That just takes you in there.
Yeah.
Have you seen what's in there?
No.
Come here.
No, I want to do it through inside.
Okay.
No, you don't have to if you don't want to.
No, you go for it, bro.
What, are you coming in with me?
You'll see why I'm not going to come in a minute. Once you're in.
Hey, watch out. You want to hold out for a second?
Mm-hmm.
I want to go off to the right.
Oh, I didn't see that.
The wire's dangling. Do you want
to? Yeah. Oh. Actually, before you go.
What, shall I go?
When you're ready.
Yeah. Fucking spider web. I can't believe that. Oh, I put my nose and it's just like covered.
Look at this mountain of a man climbing through. Moving the entire structure. He sat on it. Oh my God, I saw the floor bend.
Hey Charlie, stay there.
What the fuck, where are you going? Oh!
are you today?
I was not expecting it. I thought you were coming through here. Let me pass this up. Oh,
just to give a perspective.
That's so funny.
Yeah, I've got it.
That is so funny. I wasn't expecting you to do that. Oh my god.
So that's obviously where Charlie is, and I've just gone through a gap down there.
Your little head. Oh dear.
I mean, obviously, I've got to be careful. You see this floor inside.
Is it bad?
Right, there it is. Here it's fine. So this room. A good floor in there. I know it's when I put it 0.5 times.
Quality.
Yep. Yeah. Let me see what's here before you come through, because it might be that. Absolute pointless.
Yeah, you can see where, like, how to get the rooms, because you can see the little banister thing in the wall where to
work. I could. Oh, you know what? Shall I? Shall I?
What? You balancing? Just remember, you got to get back to. I think if you do get stuck up there, then you'll be in survival mode, so you'll be able to get back down.
Yeah.
Oh wow, I can see the floor down there.
Don't shut up. Oh, down there. Well, I thought you meant underneath me.
Down there. No, I got. Yeah, I see it bowing.
So I've just.
No, I see the floor in that room that Aiden's about to go into. It's like down at an angle. Yeah.
I'll show you guys now what it means. Look at that.
I'll have to get a clip of it from down here too. Ugh, a bit of water landed on my nose. Gross.
That's where all the roofs caved in. You see, this tree actually probably caused it. Fucked with the structural integrity, which has caused all the collapsing. Oh, is that a fireplace right there?
What? A platypus?
No, a fucking platypus.
Oh, that's what you said, right?
A fireplace.
Oh. We'll make mistakes.
Yeah, no, your mum
died. Dickhead, there's a hole above your head.
Bro, imagine that's the access to the attic. This square hole right here. For reference, I don't think my shoulders fit anyway in that.
You'd probably be able to get your massive meat head in there, that's it.
Right, me, for reference, this guy was so shook about walking on a public right of way to get here, and now he's cracking jokes like he's fucking Joe Milligan or something.
We're supposed to be boys.
Look at that roof collapse, that's a...
When you use the door handle.
But I want to spear this at his head.
I can see you. Come down the stairs.
Well, where do you want me to come now? Come on, everyone. Yellow Fanta there. Who are you trying to scare?
Oh, hello there. I'm not trying to scare no one.
From above, I showed you how the roof collapsed. This is it from the bottom. Ah, there must have been a basement or something under it. Basement or a time period, says a bunker. Look how fresh these bricks are. Like, this must have been used after World War One, contrary to what it says online. Got stuck on the door handle. Well, you're recording me, you bastard. There's me thinking he's doing a photo of me.
Yeah, I do not have good quality on there, so you won't see this.
Alright, shall I hand this back to you?
Yeah, sure. Thank you.
Wait, I'll fit through this gap.
It doesn't seem like it, does it?
Nah. How is that possible?
Ow.
Oh my god, there's a hole there.
Is there?
Yeah.
I thought we had a standard that. Is that like a gimp? Standard like this? Oh, just my face, brilliant. Not even this.
Alright, I don't think you want me to record.
No, I don't.
Look at this dribble down his shirt.
That is not dribble.
That is actual dribble, by the
no,
way.
It's not.
It's not even raining today. This guy has actually dribbled down his
top. He's a dickhead.
And then, right. Show me your shoulder. Show me your shoulder.
Right, okay, let me just clear the air. One, it's not dribble. It's water from above, unfortunately.
Rain? It hasn't been raining.
No, the water's trapped on
Yeah. Carry on.
You dickhead. Yeah.
And then a bird shat on him and he tried to scrape on it.
Bird? You cheeky bastard. Where is the remnants of bird shit?
What do you mean? The camera's seeing this.
It's green. Pass it here. What about you then, bro?
What, that? That's it. He was immature and tried wiping it on me. I can't. It's outrageous.
Yo, this guy's the biggest gaslight I've ever met.
Literally, we'll explore the little bit you wanted to do.
Yeah.
Go on, by the way, this bender is.
Oh, who are you talking me?
Oh, no,
are you talking about me?
No.
No, my mid imperial. Right, let's go.
What boxes have you got on?
What? These are my Christmas ones.
I thought so.
Yeah, I got candy canes and everything on them. My grandma got them. Oh, look at that. He dribbled.
He literally, right, you wouldn't have saw this on camera. Literally, grandma arm and dribbled on me.
Did not think I would be traversing farmland today. But we move. That way.
I didn't actually come with him, guys. While I'm doing B-roll footage and stuff, just for the YouTube content, I let him walk off. So I ain't even got his reaction or nothing.
You can hear it.
I hope this actually is catching all of me. It's on one time zoom instead of wide angle just to keep that camera quality.
You can hear it over there.
Yeah, you can.
It's like right here. There's also what appears to be a little mud path going up there on that hill.
Anyway, there is a pond over. Yeah. Oh my God, I just put my foot through.
Okay, well, that is not a river. That is. Kind of. That's it's more like a pond.
It's a pond.
Yeah, you're right.
So guys, I'm at currently one of the campsites where the camp used to be during World War One. I did do a little segment recording within the cemetery, but didn't turn out how I wanted to. I wasn't quite as comfortable. A handful of people just walking around and I felt a bit disrespectful while people are walking around to record a segment in there. I'd done it anyway, didn't turn out how I wanted. So what I'm gonna do is just overlay a few shots as I talk about, I believe it's called Magledin Cemetery. Cemetery was private during World War One. But as World War I started, come more of a use for the army during then, and an estimated 500 American soldiers were buried there, and most of them were transferred back to America after the war had ended. A handful still remain there to today. A total of 37 people from World War I who had died are currently buried there, and something like 65 or 67 World War II servers are buried there. And these are people who had died during the war. The graveyard now is for public use. Still nice to have that aspect of World War I and World War II within there. And they've got a few monuments to show for this. I presume many people watching this video probably think, oh, it's wrong for filming within a grave. That's private and sanctioned. But for me, with those heroes, and I will call them heroes, as they fought within the World War, they deserve recognition, and feel like keeping them private don't do them justice. You know, hundreds of years from now, they shouldn't be forgotten. These names should still be out there. And for me to record that and put it online a little bit just gives them the recognition they deserve. When me and Charlie done the abandoned video, we didn't give it its due diligence or its recognition it deserved. So that farm we explored that's abandoned was actually Pitt's farm during World War One, and it's got history behind it. Not much of it's reserved history. Within Morn Hill Camp, there's four minor camps made up Morn Hill Camp, and Pitt's Farm was part of one of those camps, and it's recognised on one of the maps as Pitt's Farm. It's obviously got history during World War One, and I don't think it was occupied much longer after that, but it's nice to know, and it's nice to share that with you guys. As we look, this is all now turned into butterfly conservation and a sanctuary for the butterflies within all these lands that you can see. And down the hills and up the hills. I can't really see down the hills and up the hills, but there's even more history to it. And as I pan to this, you can see between 1914 and 1990, there's a transit camp. I'll pan slightly for it so you guys can read. It accommodated up to 50,000 troops at one time, Morn Hill Camp. This actually shows where I am currently and all the camp buildings around the area. So if I carried on this walk and all across these fields, but just more accommodation. And actually, you see the road down there, what looks like a train line. That's a road, and these camps go all across it and up. So that's another hill that you're looking at. And actually, if I stand a little bit to the left, maybe a bit more than a little bit, you can kind of make out that down a hill where those tree line segments up, that's a whole new hill where those camps were positioned. And where I actually parked the car for today was the governor's office or commissioner's office for the World War One. I'll probably overlay a few different screenshots and a few images and a few maps that I found online which were interesting. And probably I'll leave them in the description as well for you guys. And while I'm doing this, Pitt's Farm was actually, by some people, apparently Percy Hobbs lived there. And Percy Hobbs was a regular at one of the pubs that me and Charlie originally parked at to traverse through. That was his local pub. And apparently he may have lived at Pitt's Farm, according to some locals. Not sure how true that story is, but it's a possibility. And because he was so recognised and familiar with the locals, the roundabout that they put near the pub is named after him, Percy Hobbs. So I'll give a little walk and talk section for this little bit as I walk along and just admire the beauty that now stands in place of quite miserable camps. If you see some of the pictures of the conditions, they flooded often. You think you're on a hill, these waters run through and down. See Winchester in the distance. That's Winchester right there. It's estimated between 2 and 3 million people pass through these transit camps. Between 500,000 and 700,000 were American troops. It was the largest used transit camp, accommodating 50,000 people at a time. And what I probably didn't mention, or I have mentioned but didn't touch on upon, 4 different mini camps made up this one major camp we know as Morn Hill. And these weren't mini camps. To accommodate for 50,000 people, you're averaging 12,500 people per camp. And if we go across here and sneak through this little section here, hopefully the camera does this justice. This is just all hills. There's a ridge line that goes down steep and up steep. I think actually what I'm looking at there, maybe St. Catherine's Hill, maybe. I know St. Catherine's Hill looks like that with the trees. When I was in the graveyard actually, the cemeteries, I should say, I was kind of surprised to see a Russian troop and a Portuguese troop buried there. I was expecting to see some American ones, but I wasn't really looking out for it. I didn't want to be disrespectful. I wanted to respect asymmetry. And it was actually two documentaries I watched on Morn Hill Camp. Something like World War II Treasure Hunters, that done a special one, Morn Hill Camp, which is World War I. So don't really fit in their series of World War II cemetery, World War II Treasure Hunters, but this place was so special, they done it anyway. And they even filmed within the cemetery, which gave me a bit of confidence to film there as well. So on this whole walk, I've just done this whole walk down here, past these fences, would have been accommodation, showers, food quarters. And when we done the abandoned segment on Pitt's farm, what you guys didn't see is me and Charlie traversing through two farm fields. And within these two farm fields, we would have passed through two of the minor camps, two camps that made up Morn Hill camps. And one of the ones we were by, it's actually photos, there was a theater that was placed there. So I've just checked one of the interactive maps for the World War I part. And right where these gates are, from what I can understand, there was a rifles court and an offices of some sort. And then as you follow down this path, it's just all men's quarters until you get a bit further down. And also, right here was a drill shed. I'm guessing a drill shed would be to some sort of orders. I want you guys to grasp how big this camp was. Look, Morn Hill Camp as a whole was massive. Even though it was four different segments with four different camps, it is fucking huge. And to accommodate 50,000 people at a time, you gotta think how many people that is. The way I can put it into perspective is if you think to football, that'd be close to capacity of Wembley. So you think that many people living within these men's quarters and other facilities, that's a lot. And actually one point I didn't pick up upon is Percy Hobbs, the pub that he went to or localed in, that pub's been there before World War I. And actually what, that pub being so close to different camps saw a lot of business, and a lot of soldiers had to be disciplined, so they kept being locals there and getting drunk. Many soldiers didn't actually stay at the camps for too long. It was a transit camp, so it was a camp you would stop off at and wait for your directions or your orders to see what the next point of interest is for you to go. And many of them would get on the train from Winchester, which is no longer in use, the train that they used. It's dismantled now, but get down to Southampton and then they get boats across to France to fight you. I'd say, what a view from this hill as well. I was saying the views are very nice here, even though it was probably very barren at the time, very miserable for the troops. It's still a pleasant view. You're seeing for miles and miles. You're right on top of the hill. And as you see down there, that's the M3. And these cars passing here, that you slightly see, down that hill was even more camps. And it just shows the fast space that these camps acquired and took over for good reason. Alright guys, so I'm towards the end of the trail that I want to walk anyway, and probably zoom in, there's a reason for that. See where the H is? Let me try to zoom right in on that for you guys. The H, hospital long stay, and if we actually go across here, that's a hospital there. So that H I pointed out, I think there's still a hospital in use. During World War I, they constructed what's known as Victoria Hospital. And that is where a lot of the troops would go to get checkups and well-beings and just used as a general hospital during World War I. And for 50,000 troops at a time, this was a small hospital. So you've got to think they were probably really overworked, especially with the conditions these troops were living in. And during rainy season where they're getting flu and all sorts, I'm guessing a lot of them would have needed to go to hospital. I don't know what medication they would have took back then, but just being seen to while you're ill would have done a lot for them. Before I close off this video, I have another two videos recorded, which is an abandoned care home and the other one is an abandoned vineyard. Now I'm also recording out of the abandoned segment or niche that I'm doing is 75 hard, which is a fitness challenge for myself. I'm going to record, document and upload. So that concludes everything. Peace.